bunch of members of parliament swearing in today. Today was the final day for MPs taking the oath of allegiance as representatives of the people in the 11th parliament. It's now done and dusted for some, including the apparently ailing Kawempe South MP Muhammad Segirinya. Segirinya was walked up to the podium, sandwiched between two ADs, before solemnly swearing in as an MP. To start business, the new legislators will elect the Speaker and Deputy Speaker on May the 24th. However, it has emerged that those who will test positive for COVID-19 will not be allowed to cast their ballot. Let's have the details on that.
Jerome Edward Katumba Wamala, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will give faithful service to this Parliament and support and uphold the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda as by law established. So help me God.
Ministers of the outgoing cabinet, including Hilary Onek, Obiga Kania, General J.J. Odon, and General Katumba Wamala, led the pack in the last day of swearing in for the 11th Parliament. After swearing in, outgoing Minister of State for Defence Okello Engola pledged to work hard to ensure that President Yoweri Museveni is elevated from General to Field Marshal.
President Museveni fits to be a Field Marshal, I can still tell you. And he qualifies. Because being a Field Marshal, you should command for 40 years, which he has done. You should do three more important issues which can make you be one, which can qualify you to that rank. Then President Museveni has done, he has kept Uganda in peace for how long? Not over 40 years now.
Ruhinda North MP Major General Kahindo Tafire, who bounced back to the 11th Parliament after losing elections in 2016, said he will not be retiring from active politics anytime soon.
My mission in this Parliament transcends what you call constitutional aspirations. Yes, I will serve my people in Metoma, but I have a greater calling for serving the people of Africa and pay homage to Uganda, my fatherland. I thank you.
Isn't it time for you to go?
Time for you to do what?
To retire.
Have you retired?
Kawempe North MP Muhammad Segirinya pledged to donate the 200 million shillings that he will receive for the purchase of a vehicle to his constituents.
Segirinya Muhammad, swear in the name of Almighty Allah that I'll be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda. So help me Allah.
I have a system in Kawempe which is called the Segi Box to give each and every family 100,000 every month. I'll be able to do that so that that money for car I'll not be able to buy. Let me use my car. That is being extravagance of the highest level.
The People's Progressive Party officially secured their first seat in Parliament after Santa Okot was sworn in to represent Padei District as woman MP.
I contested under this party already. This is the third time. I contested in 2011 and I lost. I contested again under this same party, even if people were saying the party is not known and so forth. But I say I am the one who is supposed to make the party known. So I contested again in 2016 and lost. And this time I have won. And I'm so proud for my win. And the party themselves, they're also proud for my win.
Most MPs express their commitment to supporting the parish development model, saying it will ensure socio-economic transformation.
I must be identified by the fact that I was able to provide income generating activity at a household level. In that each household must be able to have an activity that generates income on a daily basis, on a monthly basis, and the seasonal, during seasonal times.
My expectation is to see that the government, the way it operates Operation Wealth Creation, also has an input for the islanders. It is very important that islanders fish brings in a lot of money in the economy of Uganda. So it is the earliest time the government of Uganda gave a consideration to the fishermen.
Parliament spokesperson Helen Kawesa described the four-day event as 100% successful, with all 529 MPs taking oath. She announced that the new MPs will be taken through orientation.
We've registered 100% swearing in of 529 members of parliament. That's what we planned for and hoped for, and we're happy that it has happened. We've kept time. The weather was perfect. It's been as we wanted. The induction program will take place in June and to be communicated to all members of parliament. When we are more or less ready, we are finalizing that as well, the program for the induction. It will take place and it will be communicated. And we've got resourceful persons to facilitate the induction program. There's also be an orientation program from members from within the parliament. And this is also going to take place.
It was also revealed that MPs who test positive for COVID-19 will miss the speakership elections.
We've already communicated that all members of parliament are expected to take a COVID-19 test, participate in the first sitting. It's mandatory. So as it all goes, if one is found to be positive, they will be excused from that sitting. And it will be explained to them accordingly.
The first sitting will convene on May 24th, and elections of Speaker and Deputy Speaker will be first on the agenda. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.